It's Straitjacket Day here at Mucus Asylum Stadium here in Looneyapolis, Craziana, home of the Insane Colts. The first 1,000 fans will receive a free straitjacket and a 500-volt lobotomy.
Am I crazy? Or did I just see a fan throw himself off the upper deck in a garbage can with an M80 in his mouth?
No, that's their mascot, Crazy Jimmy. Quite the entertainer, isn't he? Pain, suffering, humiliation, and possibly a conga line. This game's gonna have it all. The Gnashville Lycans take on the Insane Colts. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Hope you got your mutant tailgate buzz on. I know I did. The teams are revving up on the sidelines, and we are ready for some mutant football. Grim Blitzer along with Bricks and Bricks Jr.
Yeah, Grim, I had a little eye-opener myself at the mutant bloodmobile park next to the taco truck outside. Called a lobotomy shot. Raccoon rabies blood and red bull crap. Hoo-hoo!
Yeah, I can tell your mouth looks like a hot shaving cream dispenser.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And he's running like a moose right now. Third down and forever. The QB looks angry at his offensive line, and I can't blame him. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburner. He refuses to go down. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots. Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
And it's first and 10. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message, because the messenger killed him. Ah, I'm going in circles.
And it's first and 10. And, oh, you knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. It's first and 10.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
Second down and 10. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. Third down and five. That was a good throw, assuming he was aiming for the ground. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And the runner is moving crazy fast. Look at the path he's taking upfield.
Yeah.
They let the punt drop, and it will be down by the defense. And it's first and ten. The way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is...
Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row, because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and ten. A nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. Second and three. Third down and three. A lot of guys talk about stepping up their game, Bricks. He just stepped up and blew up. He's got a lot of guts, doesn't he? And you can see the grounds crew cleaning him up now. Hot potato gets him every time. And it's first and ten.
Freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
No, still working on my salami here, Bricks. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep.
And it's first and ten. And they pick up nine with that catch.
Not enough for first.
The ref that just called that penalty, he was convicted of marrying old ladies and stealing their savings.
That sounds like a good job.
He's right at home here taking money from coaches, players, and fans.
I even saw him swiping money from the bathroom attendant. Yeah, who don't do that?
First down and seven. Second down and long. It's a glitterception. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math. Since when is that a penalty?
Since now, I guess, Grim.
Second and three. The defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. Second down and two. You can tell he's a berserk, and the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8, the greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
Oh,
Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. Force meets the explodable object. And he picks up the loose ball and rumbles into the end zone for the score. Nice going.
Hey, man, nobody can touch you when I ball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, Pop?
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably grabbed his pants.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. It's first and ten. Boom, and he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo, Grim.
And that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. And it's first and ten. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys.
With the vicious kill.
Did you know late hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schlong Galaxy phone.
It's first and ten. Second down and a lot. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run. First and ten. He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? He's not going. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get. The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Grim?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it.
First and four. Perfect pass and a score. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
good. It's the end of the first quarter, and I just want to say that this is the ugliest thing I've ever seen. Other than my mother-in-law, of course, wearing that muumuu.
Is she gonna dry clean that before she gives it back to me?
Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of it. Oh, with the brain scrambler. And it's first and ten. Quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and ten. Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. He just got crushed. And it's first and ten. Oh, great play. He is on that receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue. My tongue would get stuck to the roof of my mouth, and I couldn't talk.
Your father was a very smart man, Briggs. Very smart.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
He took a beast boost injection. Now watch him stomp all over his opponent. First down. And the running game opens up for them and allows the passing game to be more of a threat. Gotta keep him guessing. And it's first and ten. And the ball razors through the defense, cutting a defender in half. And he snags it for six. Touchdown! Touchdown! And they line up for the extra point. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die.
Oh, man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. And it's first and ten. Holy crap! He mistimed the spikes and ends up dead.
Life is full of misery, Grim. Loneliness, suffering, and then it's over much too soon.
Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. First down and forever. And this guy is supercharged with electricity. Oh, he took a leap and hit the ball, knocked out. Fumble.
He's got a case of fumbleitis.
I've never seen a demon smile so much. He says his secret is that he's poisoned the mind of 1,000 men. Whatever works, I guess. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed, it was a chip wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. And that'll be second down and 4. What?
I mean, first down!
What the hell was that?
I honestly don't know, Grim.
I don't know whose eyes the QB is using, but can we get him some new... Man, what a hit that was! It's first and 10. And like Brix's balls, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. And it's first and 10. And another interception. This quarter, if there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and 10. Caught for the first down. It's first and 10. And he held on to that one for a first down. The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
We all, Grim. We all.
Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Brix, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career. The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. You can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grim.
And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. And that's another turnover for the defense. And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
The 20. And he runs out of gas and got tackled short of the goal line. Hell of a run, though.
Lack of stamina happens to a lot of guys, Grim. At least that's what I hear.
No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
And it's first and 10.
Another interception. Easy.
Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's first and 10. Huh? one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Second down and six. It's 2 yard run before he stopped. The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock blocked the clock.
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
Same as Prince's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit sex. I took it as a cut.
And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And it's first, and that's the last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore.
Can any of us really stop the clock, Grim? I mean, when it comes right down to it, are we not all united by the constant reminder of our own mortality? Of death's constant, relentless advance? If only it was as easy as telling them.
And that's another pick. Man, oh, man. Oh, what a brutal hit. And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. Boom to the moon! Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. Knock a ball loose. No, that'll wake you up, then put you to sleep permanently.
You snooze, you lose.
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
And the offense goes into a hurry up to pick up the pace of the game. And with another pick, the QB. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
At the end of quarter two, it's a blowout. We now go to our halftime show sponsored by Monsanto Industries, makers of great killer products like Groundup. Use it on pesky weeds or neighbors, and they'll be gone by morning. Boy, these guys are going to need to pull off a huge comeback in the second half to win this game. Here comes the kickoff.
Rip the toast! Why do we even come back and bother? This is a waste of my time!
Yeah, if only one team is gonna show up, why should we have to?
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
In there and swats the ball away.
He can't catch, but he sure can swat.
Second down and 10. And he punched his way out of that. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front. No doubt about it. That guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. And he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo, Grim.
And it's first and 10. Steering a pick six, but dropped the interception.
And it plays on defense, schmuck.
Second down and 10. for a first down. Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
The offense is running low on running backs. They have only two left. They need to conserve those runners now and consider passing more. And it's first and 10. He picks up 9 yards on that catch. And that'll bring up second and 1. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. Oh, holy smokes! He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the MFL. And it's first and 10. Is getting kills.
Oh, this is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
The offense has no running backs left, so they will lose all running plays in their playbook. Now, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. Straight through the uprights. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And like a monkey trying to fuck a greased football, he gets away in a hurry. And it's first and 10. At this point, with multiple interceptions, the QB should just throw in the towel. Oh, with the brutal hit. First and 10.
First down! I've seen this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
And it's first and 10. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and 10. And the defense gets another pick. Man, rough day.
Hey, Grim, what a finish.
His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called...
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. He sits up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. And it's first and 10. And he just slipped away like a greet, and he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can see that, Grim.
And it's first and 10. No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole up here. Talking to you.
Just about met his maker on that hit.
I thought he was made in China.
I don't see any Chinese guys down there.
You're a fucking moron.
And it's first and 10. Away from that. Oh man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard?
And it's first and 10. Second down and 10. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't.
You've got to avoid those spikes or you'll be a mutant pincushion.
I was a chubby kid, Grim. My parents sent me to fat camp. My big brother told me as soon as you get there, stab the first kid you see and no one will mess with you. So I get off the bus at the camp, some kid runs up to me and stabs.
And it's first and 10. Remember, folks, in the MFL, you are allowed to touch the quarterback just like that. Second down in a very lot. And there's another fact, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit.
In your face, stupid.
And it's first and 10. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Second down and 10. First and 10. And the quarterback throws another pick. Pow! With the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10.
Ooh!
looks like there's a penalty on the play. And it's first and ten. At this point, with multiple interceptions, the QB should just put... Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone!
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay!
Yo, man, nobody can touch you an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
And it's first and ten. Second down and long. He's rumbling and he's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. And the defense scrummed it. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. He could go over. And never mind. The offense is down to their last two receivers. Once they're gone, it's game over, baby.
Those poor receivers, they're really getting the snot kicked out of them. Someone ought to just shoot them, put them out of their misery.
Don't worry, that's coming. We're tied up at the end of the third quarter. You can smell the excitement on the fans. I mean, literally, it is ripe in here. Man.
Junior, was that you?
Hey, blow me.
I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this QB. You just...
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
And it's first and ten.
You can't keep a good mutant.
Nice pass. That catch is good for 6 yards. And that'll be second down and four. Third down and long. Boom! Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
I had a dog named Snags. He doesn't play a couple.
Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
The offense is down to their final receiver. They'll be playing shorthanded for the rest of the game.
And if they lose him, will they have to forfeit? Oh, talk about pressure. I'm going to have to take the value before this one ends.
Hey, hold it out on me.
And it's first and ten. And a nice pass for a 10-yard gain.
It's not a first down in the stat line, but it's a first down in our hearts.
Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. QB know which team he's on?
I don't even know why.
He could go all the way. He's at the 40. And he put the Jets on and caught him from behind.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? Because I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
And it's first and 10. And then it's a first down from a great catch. Oh, holy Monta. With no one left on their roster, the insane Colts take a brutal loss by forfeit. It's probably a good thing the game ended up in forfeit. They weren't going to make it out of the stadium alive with this performance anyway. The fans were going to kill them if the opposition didn't.
Gotta love that fan passion.
Let's hear what the game's MVP has to say about this carnage.
I'd rather listen to Sarah Palin read the entire works of Shakespeare while tripping my brains out.
Actually, that sounds kind of fun.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Micro Hard Corporation. They get it right every